Hey, hello from a windy San Miguel de Allende, Mexico. don't mind the wind. If you travel a lot, you might be familiar with things like Trip It, kayak trips, World Mate. But I'm actually here to run through a newly updated and better than ever travel app from Google Trips. Now, Google Trips is a free app that not only helps you manage your air, hotel, ground transportation, your reservations, but it combines it with suggestions of places to visit and things to do at your destination. It's amazing, and I'll show you just how amazing it is. So let's take a look at my previous trip to Boston. And I promise never to do that accent again. I'm so sorry. What we're going to do is open the map. Nope, you're going to open the app and you're going to click on Boston. So first and foremost, you will see a purple box labeled Reservations. So right off the bat, Google Trips is going to aggregate all of your data. If you've made a travel arrangement using your Gmail address, it's going to be here under the Reservations tab. So it'll aggregate things like your flights, hotel, train, bus, car rentals, restaurant, and you can actually click on these legs for specific details. So if you want to know where you're sitting from Boston to Mexico City, it'll pull up things like your confirmation number, the gate, your departure gate, terminal, your seat number. Because my trip is already passed, these details are no longer here. But it's really helpful if you don't want to dig through your email address to find these confirmations. And let's say you didn't book something using your Gmail address, or perhaps you made an arrangement over the phone. You can click on this purple plus symbol down here, and you can manually add any details you want. It can be you input your car rental details and click save in the upper right-hand corner. I like to actually use this for notes. As you can see here, I bought tickets to a Red Sox game. Go Sox! They lost. It's irrelevant, but it's okay. I'm over it. It was really helpful for me to kind of just put the details in here so I didn't have to fish through my email for StubHub details. Actually, going back to the homepage, if you look above reservations, you will see an option to download a map of Boston. So you can toggle this button to download the map. And Google Trips will automatically upload it to Google Maps for you. Now, I love using Google Maps because it gives me access to a city both online and offline. I don't actually have to be connected to Wi-Fi to either see where I'm going or to look up points of interest. But anyway, back to the app. Below, you'll see things like things to do, food and drink, getting around. Google actually pulls a list of the top points of interest in Boston. So you can even click on these things for more details. So I'm looking at Boston Commons. From here, I can see reviews, a description of the site, directions, websites, and in some cases, even hours of operation. It is definitely the most handy way to kind of look up things to do without having to actually surf the web. And it's the same, it's going to be the same for food and drink. Let's just say I'm looking for a lunch spot, and Neptune Oyster right off the bat looks pretty good to me. I can actually star this location. And again, you get hours of operation. I can actually read through these reviews and kind of assess if this is a venue that kind of aligns with either places that I like or things that I like to do. And by clicking the star, I think I mentioned that by clicking the star for things to do, this will automatically sync with that map of the city that you've just previously downloaded. So I've just starred Boston Commons. I'm gonna just quickly show you what that looks like. So without having to physically go into, oh, I accidentally unstarted. Without having to physically open my map and kind of restart things, I can just add points of interest right from the app, which is great. So as I mentioned, I have already gone to Boston, but these stars and hearts and green areas of interest are things that I star directly from the app. You can see that Neptune oyster that I just clicked on for lunch. So this is a really handy way to save things that you're interested in without, again, having to go through and manually enter these details onto the map itself. And, you know, one of my favorite things that I'd be remiss if I didn't mention is the Getting Around tab. I absolutely love that Google Trips pulls details about the best way to travel in the city that you're in. So for me, you know, I flew into Boston Logan. I had no idea how I was going to get to, you know, I was meeting friends and family. I had no idea how to get there. And it was easy enough to click on the app and see, oh, I can take the subway. It's a blue line that connects to, you know, XYZ, and it costs $3. Whether you want to take, you know, whether you want to take public transportation or you want to hail a taxi service, Google Maps kind of aggregates, Google Trips aggregates everything for you so that you can just right off the bat see, okay, here's a major cab company. If you're driving, you know, driving rules, parking, including costs, you know, what it's like to travel the city by bike. It's everything you could possibly want to know about how to get around a certain city. But perhaps my favorite feature of this app is the need to know section, because more often than not, I will get to, you know, get to a city and have no idea how to call the police or how to find an ambulance in case of an emergency. Heaven forbid there is one, but, you know, you can actually just open this app and see, okay, here's the major hospital. Here are major pharmacies in the city that I'm in. They include, you know, currency exchange, customs on tipping. And again, these are things that I don't often look up before I travel to a new city. I should, but, you know, I forget these things until I'm there and it's, you know, it's often too late. So are there downsides to using this app? Sure. The app won't automatically update your details if you book something with a non-Gmail address or if you book something by phone. But again, you just have to manually update those details. Not a deal breaker for me, but I think it's something that you should be aware of. And there are a number of reasons, though, why I prefer this app over other ones on the market. It's free. It stores all my data that I need in one succinct place. It syncs with Google Maps, which is huge for me. I use it all the time. And it makes it really easy to plan a trip. You know, really easy to figure out if things that I am looking up align with my interests. So let us know if you download the app, if you've used it. What did you think? What features did you like? What didn't you like? And thanks for watching. I'll wait for the wind. That's why I don't wear lip gloss outside.